Hey friends, welcome back to my channel. This is Kanika from Handmade by Kanika, and today I'm sharing my video tutorial on this tissue holder, and you can see how beautiful the textures and the color is come out to be. So let's get started. The first thing I will be using is this Art Essential Heavy Gesso in the color black from immix. Next I will be using the immix texture paste. And then I will also use the immix metallic paint in the color bronze moon. Next, I'm going to use the citrus yellow sprinkle mist. And also I will use the burnt orange sprinkle mist. And apart from this, I will also be using the persimmon color sprinkle mist. All these are from immix itself. And last, I will be using the chestnut sprinkle mist. Then I will be using this beautiful chippy, background chippy from Expression Scrap. So to start off, I am just using my MDF tissue holder and I am just applying one coat of black heavy gesso. If you are using MDF base, make sure you sand it. Mine was already done. Right now I am not coloring the inside of the box. Later on I will do that. So here you can see with the one coat how it looks. Now I'll just start to give a texture. So for that I'm using this immix mini stencil. Also I'm going to use the texture paste with the stencil to give a very nice 3D texture, you can say. So I'll just randomly go over with my stencil and texture paste to create a beautiful background. Also, if you're enjoying this video, then don't forget to hit the like button and do subscribe to our channel if you're new. If you want, you can use different types of stencils as well, but I wanted my base texture to look very even, so I'm using only one stencil. But Expressions Craft has a huge variety of stencils available, so do check out their website. So similarly, like the top, I will cover all the sides as well with the texture. I'm taking this chippy and I'm just cutting off each square so that I don't want to use this chippy as a whole, but I want to use this chippy in parts. So I'm just trimming off all the squares so that I can add on the beautiful chippy differently. To adhere it, I'm using the immix texture paste because it will give a very nice background texture, and my chippy will get sticked very well to the base. So as this chippy has openings in the as per the design, so on the base as well it will give a very nice texture and the chippy will literally be sticked very well. Like this, I have sticked four of the parts on the corners. Next, I am just giving a random texture with my texture paste, and then I am just using my grainy texture paste, which is the DIY. If you have seen my previous videos, you have seen how I made that. So using that, I am just giving a fine texture. I have cut off all these chippies into parts and now I'm going to stick them like this. So on the front here you can see I stick these two, and on the side I am just sticking one on the center. So this is how it looks, and now I am going to use my deco stones, that are the mega and the mini ones, and I'm going to give a very fine texture and nice texture with the deco stones. Also, if you want, you can randomly place these, but if you want in a particular direction or way, like here what I am doing, you can do that as well. But trust me, the deco stones gives a very nice texture as well as finished touch up, as if you have seen my previous projects, I have used them a lot. And also do check the live video which I did on my Facebook and showed the different ways to use. So similarly, I'm going to just give a very nice texture to the sides as well using my stencil and the texture paste, and then again I will use my deco stones to give a nice texture. So this is how it looks after the texture using the chippies, the texture paste and deco stones is given. So now I'll just cover the whole base using my white gesso. And here you can see I'm just done with the layering part. So here I'm just applying one fine coat of white gesso. And as soon as it dries, I'll start to use my sprinkle mist. So here I'm starting off with the citrus yellow. I'm building the layers with the lightest color to the darkest color. Make sure you just shake your bottle very well before using. So I have used the citrus yellow and now I'm just drying this layer. What I love using the sprinkle mist is with each layer I dry so that it gets settled very well, and then I use the next layer with a different color. So Expressions Craft has a wide variety of sprinkle mist, so do check their website. So for the next layer, I'm using the burnt orange, and again I'm just going to sprinkle this to create a very blended and very nice effect. To just blend the two colors here, I'm just spritzing some water and I'm just moving my base so that both the colors get blended very well, and again I will just heat dry it. If you want, you can let it get settled naturally as well. And then I'm just building the layers using my persimmon, chestnut, burnt orange and citrus yellow. Like I'm just again and again just using the colors to give a very darker shade, and I'm just applying the colors and then I'm just drying it. For using multiple layers, make sure that your previous layer gets dried very well. This is how the top of my tissue holder looks like, and here you can see the beautiful textures which have come out. Similarly, I will just color all the sides, and then after covering that, I'll just cover the inside and the back using my black heavy gesso. So here, to give a very nice metallic finish, I'm using my metallic paint in the color Bronze Moon, and I'm just adding the color using my fingers. So here you can see how beautiful the colors have come out to be. Similarly, I'll cover these the leftover portions with the sprinkle mist as well. So here you can see I am just done coloring with the sprinkle mist on the sides as well, and don't worry, on the base and on the inside portion I'll cover at last using my black heavy gesso from immix. But till then I will just use my metallic paint on the sides to give a very nice finish as well again. Now I'm done coloring. So for the inside, I'm using my black heavy gesso, and I'm just covering the inside with the black heavy gesso so that my inside looks as neat and beautiful as the outside of the tissue holder looks. So one coat of heavy gesso is more than enough. So here you can see I'm done coloring, and this is how my inside looks. Although I'll just give a very nice coat on the back again, as I worked with the color, so I have got that look. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you did, then do like, comment, share and subscribe to our channel if you're new. Until then, happy crafting, and you can buy all the products on www.expressionscraft.in. Happy crafting!